Welcome to the season finale, season 5 of RGB Stars Live with Alex Arabia and Isaac Medina. Remember, RGB Stars is
the premier platform for showcasing real Grand Valley talent
and the RGB celebrities place to be. And today we have an outstanding guest to end up with this 5th season of RGB Stars, Mr. Mario Reyna.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for being here. You used to be a dean at South Texas College. You're now a business consultant.
You have
a great background. And today our viewers will get to know a little bit more about your career and what you've done, your future goals, and anything else you want to share.
Absolutely.
Awesome. We're so happy to have you here. So, Mr. Reyna, tell us a little bit about where you're from, what you do, your degrees, family, anything you want to share with us.
Sure. You know, I grew up in Mission initially. Then after a few years, we moved to Alton, Texas. It wasn't called Alton back then. It was just El Cinco. So I grew up in the Mission area primarily. Once I was done with high school, I did attend, back then it was called Pan American University. I went there for about a year, and then I joined the Air Force. And so I stayed with the Air Force almost 20 years. I retired from the Air Force. And during that time, from 1976 to 1995, you know, so the Air Force took us to many places. You know, initially the training is in San Antonio, Lackland Air Force Base. Then we went to Lowry Air Force Base, which is outside of Denver. After that, they sent us to Vandenberg. Now, Vandenberg is a very special place. Vandenberg Air Force Base is in next to Santa Maria, California. To give you a better perspective where Vandenberg is, it's about 40 miles where Michael Jackson used to live,
okay?
In Neverland.
Interesting.
Oh, yeah.
Neverland, whatever he used to call it. So if you can remember Michael Jackson, well, the base was, and
did you ever visit the place, by the way?
Neverland. I was there about 12 days ago, and we drove by Neverland, but you can't go in. Mm-hmm. It's outside of a little town called Los Olivos. Anyway, so it's a beautiful area, you know, Vandenberg, and Vandenberg is a missile test base. So anytime that you see a movie where missiles are going off, that's Vandenberg, you know, primarily Vandenberg. So after Vandenberg, I went to school there. I went to Allen Hancock College in Santa Maria. And so, of course, I have AA degree from there. And then I went to school at the University of Laverne. Laverne is in California, so I have a bachelor's in management from them. So after that, you know, I applied for a commission, but they were only, at that time, they only wanted the missile guys, and I wasn't interested in being in a missile system. So I joined recruiting service. I came to Corpus Christi for 3 years, and it was at that time that I was selected for a commission. So I went back to Lackland Air Force Base to go through officer training school. So I did that for about 13, 14 weeks. I got commissioned as second lieutenant. From there, I went to Loring Air Force Base, and I was there for almost 2 years at Loring. Loring is way up north, next to the Canadian border. Mm-hmm. So it was a fabulous experience. You had snow like 7 months out of the year. It was a beautiful, but I only say they're
very different from the valley.
You know, I kid you not, there were days when the weather would be about 50 below zero with the wind chill factor. So if it was like 30 degrees outside, we'd be wearing shorts, playing football and whatnot. So after Vandenberg, I went to Zaragoza Air Force Base in Spain, and I was there for 4 years. This is between 87 and 91. From 91 to 94, I came back to Lackland Air Force Base, and then from Lackland, I went to Herbert Field in Florida, Fort Walton.
How many years is that in the military?
Almost 20 years.
20 years, and then when did the transition from that to
STC?
And it was also over 20 years at STC, right?
So it happened right away, so I got out of the Air Force, and then I started STC. So I got out at the end of 1995. I started STC in 1996. So STC, you know, initially when it was a little baby school.
STCC at the time.
STCC. Yeah.
Community College.
Community College. It was a little school. We had maybe 3,000, 4,000 students. when I arrived. So back then, the academic programs were organized as divisions. So I came in as the director for the division of business, and then throughout the years, you know, things changed a little bit here and there. Then I became the dean, and then I became the dean for business, math and science, then the dean for math and science and technology. Then I became the dean for public safety and technology. Mm-hmm. So it was always changing.
And also the administrator of the technology campus.
And the Mid Valley at one time, I was the Mid Valley coordinator. So we did all those fantastic things. So we went from maybe 3,000 or 4,000 students to maybe 32, 33 when I left.
Wow, that's huge.
And several campuses across Sarita County.
So when we arrived here, it was just a little bitty Beacon campus. We didn't have the technology campus. We didn't have the STAR campus. We didn't have the Mid Valley campus. We didn't have the regional center.
Nursing.
Yeah. We didn't have anything. But that happened during my tenure at SDC.
And the virtual campus.
Who can forget about the virtual campus?
And dual credit.
Dual credit. So those were all things that happened during my time there. So as far as degrees go, so I have a bachelor's degree. I have a master's in public administration. And then I continued going to taking classes in the business area. So I took a lot of business, a lot of accounting at the master's level. So that's what I've done when it comes to education.
Awesome. What would you say, in all those years in the military and at the college, would be your biggest achievement and also your biggest obstacle?
Well, when you look back, you think that everything was fine. I said that good, everything is fine. You know, but so I tell you, what changed my life was one. I graduated with my bachelor's degree, and then I got commissioned. After those two things happened, you know, my life changed completely. Changed completely in a sense that we had more things. Economically, you had more things.
Yes.
You know, so after that, everything just kind of mushroomed, and it went well. So what was hard about it? Well, it's hard, first of all, to get in the Air Force, and then it's hard to go through a program like OTS. You know, you just can't go to Walmart and buy the uniform, put it on, and say, I'm an officer. It doesn't work that way. It doesn't work
that way. It's that easy.
Lots of hard work and sacrifice.
Mm-hmm. It doesn't work that way. So there's things, now you look back, but going through the process, it's a life-changing process. You have to remember that in one phase of my career, I was being transformed from a civilian to an Air Force guy when I went through basic training. And then in the other process, when I went through OTS, Officer Training School, you're being transformed into so-called becoming an officer and a gentleman. Two different categories. An officer and a gentleman. So you have to learn those etiquettes, and you have to learn about all kinds of things, that military studies and, you know, presentations and writing and organizational behavior, military bearing, and you have to be able to conduct all kinds of maneuvers. And so now that I've done it, it's fine. You know, when I was doing it, it was probably not fine. So I was there for, like I said, 13, 14 weeks. And every week when I was at OTS, you would have at least two assignments that were measured. And every measurement, you had to get an 80 or better. If not, you're out.
Wow.
You know, so it's
very competitive.
So you can just imagine the how all of us sweated, you know. And so I'm a guy from here, man. I'm a guy like you guys. I went lived in Alton. So you have guys around you that have gone to all what you would think, you know, fancy schools. You know, I went to the schools that I went to. So you would say, wow. So I was with those people there, and I did better than most. So it's something that you look back.
And you retired right before the pandemic from STC, right? I remember you were one of our last speakers at STC with the Psychology Club.
I was, because I left in February, and they shut everything down in March.
Yeah.
Everybody go home.
What have you done since? What are you doing now?
You know, so now what I do, I'm a business consultant. So I help people out, you know, bring more business to their organizations. And another thing that I do, You know, I'm a, what you call a day trader.
Okay.
So in the mornings, I get up.
Crypto,
you know,
or stock?
I buy and sell stocks.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah. So I buy and sell those kind of things. So I get up in the morning. I read the financials. I learned, you know, how to use the tools to analyze how a stock might do during the day. So overall, I mean, this is what I use right now is money that ordinarily I would have in the bank. And so I'm doing very well. So if I lose it, it's no big deal.
Have you tried cryptocurrency yet?
No, I don't like it. I don't like it. And I don't recommend any of you to do cryptocurrency because the risk and the reward is so, the rewards are huge, but the risks are also the same.
Very volatile.
So unless you have a lot of money that you don't care about, go ahead and do it. But I don't recommend it.
And where do you see yourself in the future? Future goals, 5 to 10 years from now?
You know, I think, you know, right now, I feel like a kid, you know, believe it or not. So I'm doing whatever the heck I'm doing, and I'm trying to see what is it that I can do different. I don't need to do anything, but I'm trying to do something different. And so I think the expectations is for me to continue helping people in business, but having a major part in that particular operation. You know, I don't want to be involved in leading people. I don't want to do that part. I want to be involved in bringing business to the business, you know. So that's, I think, it's where I'm focused in. You know, I've done my share of leadership in organizations, and that was fun. I enjoyed it, but now I just want to concentrate just myself and how much I can bring to the business.
Awesome. And where can we find you and your business on social media?
Yeah, just Mario Reyna. You know, I'm on Facebook, LinkedIn. Just look up Mario Reyna. They're very easy to find.
There you go.
Any closing remark or message to our viewers?
Yeah, you know, I think I like what they are doing with the RGV Stars. I think it's a fabulous program. But, you know, one of the questions was, you know, what do I recommend?
Advice.
Yeah, like. Yeah. So I recommend that you read a lot. You know, like I was telling you, in the mornings I get up at 6 o'clock in the morning and I read for a couple hours every day, at least a couple hours, to try to understand what's going to happen that day. So when I used to teach a class, and I would tell the students, read, because if you don't read, you're not going to get ahead in life.
Yeah.
And so my recommendation is obviously go to school and read as much as you can. And if you do that, then you're going to see the opportunities that are available to you. There's so many opportunities, but if you don't read about it, you'll never know that they're there. But go to school and read as much as you can, and you'll be successful.
Excellent.
Awesome. Great advice.
And to many of us, you'll always be Mr. Reyna or Dean Reyna.
Thank you.
Mario Reyna, thank you so much for spending time here with us, inspiring our viewers, and we wish you the best.
Thank you so much.
More success, more blessings.
There you go.
And this was our season finale. You're here on our last episode for this season, season 5 of RGV Stars, live with Alex Saravia and Isaac Medina. Tune in for season 6 soon.
And we are the premier platform for showcasing Rio Grande Valley talent
and the RGV celebrities' place to be. Thank you for watching.
Till next time.